Hey guys, welcome to a brand new episode of Song Theory. If you haven't already, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Now, I know you guys are probably a little freaked out right now with everything going on in the news, with this sickness going around, and I know it sucks. There's a lot going on. I of course, am a little concerned myself. I have had 3 collapsed lungs. I have asthma as well, so I am not necessarily the one to be outside right now. So I decided to stay inside and just be on my phone along with my family. We're not going anywhere, and I hope you aren't either, unless you have to. So today we're actually going to go through a playlist of songs that you can listen to while you are on quarantine with me and the rest of my family, because, you know, since I have no school to go to and no work to go to, I figured I might as well go ahead and pump out videos every single day of the week. So this week, today, specifically, we're doing the Spotify Top 10 Favorite Songs for Quarantine. Let's get started. So for me, of course, I'm going from 10 to 1, so from, you know, what I think is good to the very best, and I hope you guys do this too. And in the comments below, tell me what you think the top 10 should be and the songs that you know about or whatever. Now, the reason I got this idea was actually because I was on Twitter and I saw people kind of floating around a list of songs that they could listen to, and I picked my top 10 favorites. So number 1 is actually Jordan Sparks' No Air. Now, I don't know if you guys have heard this song before, but No Air is actually very specific because it's a great love song. Well, it's kind of a heartbreak song. It's about how Jordan Sparks was so in love with this person, and she can't live without them. Literally, if she were to live without them, then she would have no air to breathe. And once again, this is pretty poignant considering I have asthma and I've had 3 lung collapses. So if I were ever to be affected by this particular sickness, then I would probably be talking about how I have no air as well. So there's that. I also love Jordan Sparks. I think she's a fantastic artist. I really wish she would make more music. I haven't heard much from her lately. But anyway, that would be my number 10 is Jordan Sparks' No Air. Now, number 9 is actually from a band that I personally love. I found this band one day. I was watching a commercial for a car. I think it was Cadillac or something. And then I heard this familiar beat. And I was like, wow, this beat is incredible. Who is this? And back then, they didn't have things like Google where you can say, hey, what's this song? They didn't have, you know, like anything like that. So I had to figure it out, and I had to go on Google and type in car commercial with this song. Anyway, it turned out to be a French band by the name of Phoenix. And one of my favorite songs from them is If I Ever Feel Better. Now, I like this song a lot, and especially if you go on YouTube, and I'm gonna put the link below for all these songs. There's music videos to all these, I believe. And if you look in this particular music video, I like it a lot because I really enjoy the music video, the layout, the context. I love it. So please go watch it. It's a really fun video. It's a great song. And once again, very on point with what's going on right now. My number 8 would be Toxic from Britney Spears. Obviously. If when you look at Britney Spears and you look at the songs that she's made, I mean, you cannot deny the fact that Britney Spears has had an incredible impact on everybody when it comes to music. I mean, her showmanship, her musical abilities. I mean, yeah, she went, you know, kind of, you know, downhill for a while, but who hasn't? You know what I mean? And so I really like this song because, once again, Toxic. I like this song because it's really fun. And I think that when you listen to a song like this, it actually kind of gets you up, gets you dancing a little bit. And I really do like that about Britney Spears' song. So, boom, that's my number 8, Toxic, Britney Spears. Now, my number 7 is a song I actually heard recently. I wasn't really a big fan of it when I first heard it, but it's actually, it's Mask Off from Future. Now, Mask Off is pretty dope because I really like the beat. The lyrics are okay, but the beat is dope. The actual music is incredible. I think it's the flute that's probably what does it for me. Like, once again, all of these songs are in the description box below. Go click on it, look at the music video, look at the song, listen to it, it's great. But I think it's the flute, that melody. I feel like I've heard that melody somewhere before, and that's probably why that song strikes me the way it does, because the melody sounds extremely familiar. I'm not quite sure where I've heard it from, but it sounds familiar. But anyway, that's my number 7, Mask Off, Future. So my number 6 on the list is actually Maroon 5, one of my favorite bands, personally, when it comes to pop. I've been listening to them since I was a kid. honestly. And one of my favorite songs from them is Sunday Morning. Sunday morning rain is falling. I don't feel like singing. Anyway, it's a great song, and one of their other great songs that I love, especially for this quarantine playlist, is Harder to Breathe. Once again, super poignant with a gentleman that has asthma. Okay? Love these. This song in particular is great because it is very passionate. I think it's really hard edge, and I really like the, if you listen to it, the bridge. I love the bridge into the chorus. I love it. And I think that's a song that you guys should definitely listen to. Maroon 5, people have been kind of giving them crap for a long time, especially after their Super Bowl performance. But let's not talk about that. We're not going to go there, but listen to the song. It's great. That, I mean, it's for my quarantine playlist anyway. If you guys, once again, find another quarantine playlist that you like, put it in the comments below. I want to see what you guys think. Now, anyway, that's my number 6, Harder to Breathe from Maroon 5. Now, my number 5 is actually a really old song from an artist that I don't think any of you have heard of. The song is called I'm Leaving on a Jet Plane from John Denver. Now, I'm going to sing a part of it, and I feel like you guys have heard this before, okay? I know you haven't sat and listened to it on Spotify before, but I know you've heard it either on a commercial or a TV show. Just let me indulge you. Here we go. I'm leaving on a jet plane. Don't know if I'll be back again. You've heard it. You've heard it, right? I see you. Look at you. Okay, I've heard it. I've listened to it. It's a great song. And really, I implore you to actually listen to the entire song. It's very good. John Denver actually is one of those artists that have very little notoriety for some reason. At least I haven't heard much about him. Once again, he's an older artist, so maybe that has a lot to do with it. But go check out his playlist. Check out, you know, that song in general. Leaving on a jet plane is something I would love to do, but because of the sickness that's going around, the only place you can really go to is either Iceland or Antarctica. So, yeah, I mean, if you were to leave on a jet plane, don't know where you're going, because it's everywhere. It's everywhere. Now, my number 4 is actually going to be Do You Want to Die Together from a band called Stars. Now, I just recently listened to this song, and I think it's actually very sweet. I don't know a lot about Stars. This is my first time ever hearing about them or hearing a song from them. Once again, link below. And I think the way I felt about the song was actually pretty, like, it felt pretty like dark, but at the same time, kind of like the way that the tonality went, it's in major, right? It's in a major key. It's not minor, so it's not like this, but it's like this, right? So it makes you feel happy, but like the lyrics are extremely like not happy. So go listen to the song. Tell me what you think. But it's basically just about a couple, and they're like, you want to die together? And the other one's like, no, let's live. And then you want to die together? It's a story. Go listen to it. I think it's pretty important and on point for everything that's going on right now. I don't want to die together with nobody or at all. But once again, this song, kind of fitting. So go listen to that. Do You Want to Die Together by Stars. Now, my number 3 is actually, honestly, one of my favorite oldies songs. Okay, when I say oldies, I mean like back from the 60s and 70s, all right? I'm going to hit you with a little bit of Bee Gees. Now, I know y'all have heard this song before.
Staying alive.
Y'all have heard it. Stop playing. Staying Alive by the Bee Gees. Now, staying alive is our primary goal, and that's why we're staying inside. You get it? A little bit of social distancing humor. You like that? Okay. That's fine. The Bee Gees, their entire discography is fantastic. If you haven't heard the Bee Gees before, quite honestly, are you even a music fan? Are you even a music fan? Because I don't think so. If you haven't heard the Bee Gees, I don't think you're a big music fan at all, because the Bee Gees encouraged almost every pop artist ever. So if you haven't heard the Bee Gees, go listen to it. Once again, link is below to all of these songs. There's no reason why you can't listen to it. You're at home doing nothing. And that's also why you should subscribe to my channel. Thanks. Now, my number 2 is one of the most popular songs of last year, and it's from one of my favorite artists, okay? Travis Scott. Now, I feel like you already know what I'm gonna say. So, because you already do, I'm gonna go ahead and just kind of explain why this is the case. First of all, the music video to this song is one of the best music videos I have ever seen. Now, mind you, I have been exposed to Peter Gabriel's song Sledgehammer, that music video. I've been exposed to some fantastic music videos from Lyrical Lemonade, which, I mean, that guy makes incredible music videos. But this music video was off the charts. Sicko Mode. If you haven't seen the music video to Sicko Mode, what is wrong with you? You gotta go see it. You gotta watch it. You gotta listen to it. It is fantastic. I doubt any of you out there have not seen it or listened to it. So there's that. But that would be my number two. Absolutely. Sicko Mode. Like, I know the title is just about being sick and stuff, but like, it doesn't matter. It's a great song. It's on my list. Leave me alone. And finally, the coveted number one spot on this list, the one that we cannot ignore, my personal favorite for this quarantine list, is something near and dear to my heart, because I am a listener of all types of music, whether it's rock, whether it's hard metal, whether it's hip hop, whether it's pop, doesn't matter. But I also love me some Christian music, some gospel music, encouraging, uplifting. I absolutely love it. It fills my soul with joy. And one of the songs I believe fits this list the best is Carrie Underwood's Jesus Take the Wheel. Because let me tell you something, people, Jesus need to take the wheel right about now, because I done let my hands go. I don't know what else to do. Everything shut down. School done shut down. Work done shut down. Well, not my work. I actually left. But everything shut down. I mean, like, you can't go nowhere. This is the great shutdown. But even in the midst of all this anxiety and worry, I listen to songs like Jesus Take the Wheel from Carrie Underwood, because it brings me joy, it makes me feel good, and I just love gospel music in general, because that's what it does, that's what it's designed to do. Once again, I know right now times are a little hard, and this channel doesn't really talk about a lot of seriously deep political stuff, and I won't even really go there, but I think one thing we have to think about right now, especially during the great shutdown, is that while you're sitting at home and you might not be able to go out or go to school or go to work or go to the park or wherever, you do have people next to you that you can enjoy time with. Me and my wife have spent more time together than I thought we would in months. I've gotten the most rest I've gotten in months. Me and my parents, we've spent time together as well, and we're all just having a great time. We're having fun. And I think that even in the midst of everything we've lost, it's important to look at what we still have. We have our health, we have each other, and by God, we have toilet paper in the pantry, in the laundry room, in the bathroom, under my bed. Look at what you have and be thankful. Now, hopefully you enjoyed this quarantine top 10 list of mine. Please tell me if you guys have a top 10 list of your own. I'd love to see it, read it, listen to it. I'm excited because, once again, there's nothing else to do. Y'all ain't got nowhere to go, nothing to do. Great. Watch my videos, because I'll be posting one every day. And guess what? You guys can subscribe and hit the like button while you're at it, because what else do you have to do, right? Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Stay encouraged, stay healthy, stay inside. I love you guys. I hope you have a great day, and I proclaim right now that you guys will have a better tomorrow. God bless. I'll see you all later.